Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Rahul Tawar, junior resident in radio diagnosis in PGIMS Rohtak. I am presenting my oral paper on spinopelvic alignment on MRI in young adults with spondylolisthesis. Low back pain is one of the most common causes of medical visits globally. The prevalence of low back pain in adults has been recorded as high as 60% to 90%. Low back pain is a very frequent disease that most of the people experience at some point of their lives. 1 year incidence of first episode of low back pain is between 6.3% and 15.4%, whereas incidence of any episode of low back pain is between 1.5% and 36%. Abnormal spinopelvic parameters leads to sagittal imbalance and contributes to multiple spinal conditions including ischemic spondylolysis, degenerative spondylolisthesis, deformity and influences the outcome after spine correction surgery. Therefore, restoration and maintenance of normal sagittal alignment is crucial for better outcomes of spine surgery. There is a great variation in sagittal spinopelvic alignment in normal population with wide range of normal parameter. So an ideal sagittal alignment is one in which an individual is able to maintain a stable standing posture with minimum energy expenditure. There are a lot of parameters and angles in lumbosacropelvic curvature that have been measured in many studies. Its effect on sagittal imbalance and disc degeneration has been done, and these studies have different conclusions. Some of them used magnetic resonance imaging and X-rays, while others used only X-rays. Aims and objectives. The purpose of our study is first to evaluate spinopelvic alignment on MRI in young Indian adults presenting with low backache, to evaluate coronal and sagittal curvature of spine and its association with spondylolisthesis, to correlate between disc degeneration and patients with spondylolisthesis. Materials and methods. 100 young Indian patients presenting to Department of Radiodiagnosis with low backache were studied by MRI. Whole body MRI was performed in addition to evaluation of the lumbar spine. These were then divided into following two groups: degenerative spondylolisthesis, 43 of them, and degenerative disc disease and no spondylolisthesis group, that is NDLS, 57 in number. Inclusion criteria. All patients younger than and equal to 40 years with suspected disc degeneration presenting with back pain. Exclusion criteria. Patients greater than 40 years, patient with recent and past history of significant trauma, patients with clinical diagnosis of any inflammation or infection, patients with suspected or diagnosed tumor, patient with any congenital malformation, except congenital lumbar spinal stenosis, patients with systemic disease, patients with contraindications to MRI, details of the imaging technique used, patients with suspected spondylolisthesis using MRI, 3 Tesla MRI examination used following protocol, whole spine T2 weighted sagittal imaging, whole spine T1 weighted coronal imaging, sagittal and axial images of the lumbar spine. Parameters used were sagittal vertical axis, sacral angle, sacral inclination, sacrospinal angle, sacral table angle, vertical angle of the sacral curvature, thoracic kyphosis, coronal imbalance, sacral slope, lumbar lordosis, Cobb angle. Cobb angle, it is an angle between line drawn at the top of the superior tilted vertebra and the bottom of the inferior tilted vertebra. Statistical analysis. All the values are expressed as the mean plus minus standard deviation. Data were analyzed using the statistical package for the social sciences version. The comparison between parameters are performed using analysis of variance, example t-test. One-way t-test was used for quantitative variables and level of significance was set at 0.05. Results. Age group of DLS group is 29.69 plus minus 5.26 years. Age group of NDLS group is 29.52 plus minus 6.57 years. Male ratio female of DLS group is 21:22. Male ratio female of NDLS group is 28:29. So these are the following readings of the, these are the parameters. Then is the DLS group. Then is the details of this NDLS. Then is the readings. All the readings are there. According to gender, they have been recorded and presented in the tabular form. This is for the female gender. All the parameters are mentioned here. No statistically significant correlation was found with respect to any of these parameters. Statistically significant difference was found between the two genders, that is male ratio female is 49 to 51, with respect to SVA, LL, SI, and VASC. However, only COPS angle was statistically different between the two groups when the genders were taken separately. There was positive SVA in 8 patients, that is 18.6% of the DLS group, and of 5 patients, that is 8.8% of NDLS group. No significant correlation was found between SVA of the two groups. Conclusion. The COPS angle was significantly higher in the young Indian females, while it was significantly lower in the males with DLS. Authors could not find any study on the Indian population. They also could not find a study with similar findings. However, most studies have been performed on parameters taken on X-rays in patients of all groups. Thank you.